right, let's get it the way that it is, because I think that this is being diluted, and people who are not in the music industry don't really understand what's going on. Okay, this is the whole thing. Okay, iPhone 6 has just launched, and they launched the Apple Watch. And at the same time, they gave away U2's album for free. Basically, what they're doing is they have come up with this unbelievable marketing campaign to sell phones and watches. And at the same time, they think they're doing you a favor by giving you away mediocre music for free. Now, the reason why they're giving this away for free is U2's record sales have dropped. They are still the biggest rock band in the world, still one of the greatest rock bands in the world. But as far as writing new music, they are in that bracket that many people in their age group fall into. Their music isn't relevant and doesn't sell like it used to. People are quite happy with that, but U2 have to be number one at everything they do. Now, instead of releasing an album and it softly goes into number one, then it falls, they don't like that. So they want to be the biggest, best in the world. Give it away for free, whether you want it or not. Mm-hmm. You turn on, okay, your device, you get their music. Whether you like it or not, it's there. You cannot get rid of it. It fills up space. It fills up space on your iPhone, okay? Now, what would you do if you woke up tomorrow morning and Obama's last speech was on your iPhone, and every time you turned on your music or your shuffle or you wanted to be entertained, you heard Obama or you heard the talk every day? What would you do? This is an invasion of my private space, my entertainment space, okay? All right, take that. And then all this is I've ordered a new iPhone, which is nearly $1,000. How many people have ordered a new iPhone? All my friends have. This is an unbelievable marketing experience to sell the new iPhone, order a new watch, and guess what? We love you so much, you're getting U2's music for free as an added bonus. Now, this gentleman, okay, by the name of Paul Quirk, wrote this article much better than I could, but this is what it is. Giving away music like this is damaging to the value of music as privacy, and those who will suffer most are the artists of tomorrow. You two have had their career, but if one of the biggest rock bands in the world are prepared to give away their album for free, how can we really expect the public to spend dollars on an album by a new coming artist? They set the precedent that music is disposable. It's just another piece of software and it's nothing. You should give it away for free. Sorry, guys, people, there's a whole new breed of artists coming up that need that money to survive, to be able to continue to create. We're not all billionaires. We're not all in your world. So stop with your doing us a favor by giving it away for free. Keep it to yourself.